In 1819, fascinated by the magic of Oran through the Orientalist painting and literature, two friends decided to leave England to travel around the Mediterranean.
In the attempt to live the Orientalist dream, they followed the track of famous painters in Constantinople, Cairo, Alger, and Tangier.
From each city, they sent letters back to England to share their impressions with their relatives.
January 21st, 1890.
My dear Mary, we just arrived in Constantinople. As scheduled, we took the train from Paris. What a fantastic journey.
Our fellow travelers came from all over Europe and shared our enthusiasm. The general atmosphere was excellent. They recited Bajazet of Racine while we talked to them about Beckford and Shelley. We had all read the travel story of Chateaubriand from Paris to Jerusalem.
We are all convinced to be at the beginning of an initiatory journey. Napoleon campaigns in Egypt and the colonial expansion paved us the way. At last, we are going to get to know the world of the 1001 Nights. Thanks to the Orientalist movement, we all already dreamt so many times of it.
Following Flaubert's tracks, we have been all over Constantinople and we've admired its beauty. We are falling for its mosques, which animate the public space. They hold so many performances, like musicians, snake charmers, or dancing dervish.
The most beautiful is Saint Sophia, which inspires so many painters. It is an ancient cathedral which has been turned into a mosque. I am still stunned by its beauty. In 1847, Gaspar Fossati and his brother have been hired by the Sultan to restore the basilic. They had the brilliant idea to immortalize the mosque in drawing during the restoration. The interior is covered with white marble. The dome seems to float. It is decorated with wonderful mosaics, with very fine designs. Thanks to its many openings, the space is full of light.
Next month we will leave Constantinople and go to Cairo by boat.
Do not worry, we will send you letters from each of us.
Al-Qa'ira, 15 مارس 1890 عزيزتي ماري أكتب لك من بلادي ألف ليلة وليلة والأحرام
لكدا وساء لنا من أكسندرية حوغا صحراء جيزة في نفس هذا المكان كيد كمنات حرب الهرم من كبلة بونابارت
أخيل أم من فوق هذه الأحرام هم لك 40 كرنة يشاهدونكم كانتي الأحرام بيالكدي مريف في الفوك
في الكايراتي سأغرق في أشوار الزايكاتي والمغربراتي من هايل الحاشدي وفاودا الكول الحاملة والحامل
أشوار ريزو وزي جلو موزدا حيمتا بباراتي الساجدي الوانية وعوال في هاتيا هاونكا آدها باردهي آنيينيا والمساريهنا سهارا الترابي
بفضل صديقتي إليزابيث جريشو بومانس التكايت بالنساء مصرتي نحن بعيدنا عن أوهام الرسميين والكتب لدينا يسهل لنا علم فيها مساء شريكة كان متعة رام ريحة على عكس ما وصفه المعتنى عن حياة الحرم أن سلسنا يقضينا يرمحنا مستلقيات عن الغايات مزيانة بالذهب والحجر الكريم بينما الهادم والعبيد وكيفنا أمامها ازدعدام لهذا مثون بلى المساء اللواتي التكيتهما يسهى غلنا ويكون بتربية أبنائهم أسطورة تنهار
قريبا سنندم إلى كفلة إلى جزائري أخشى غالبا من أجل الراحة Junio 15, 1890. Mi querida Marie.
Llegamos a Alger después de cruzar el desierto durante dos meses en camello.
Hemos integrado una caravana de comerciantes de oro y de marfil. Los caravaneros son personas muy hospitalarias y piadosas. Su vida es simple.
Las etapas nos permitían conocerlos mejor. hemos compartido su estilo de vida.
Entre estas paradas, el desierto era tranquilo, inundado de luz, desolado, como en un sueño. Hacía tan calor, el calor venía en oleadas sucesivas.
Los espejismos parecían indicar oasis, pero el sitio donde llegábamos era seco, no agua, nada. A veces un camello caía y era abandonado. Encontrábamos muchas de estas carcasas blanqueadas por el sol.
En peregrinos yendo a la Meca, Beni utiliza un procedimiento casi fotográfico. Se tiene la impresión de ser parte del convoy. De hecho, el caravana inundada de luz que progresa en el desierto hacia la Meca es muy realista. Los personajes y los camellos son tratados con una precisión escrupulosa. Beni detalla los rostros y los trajes tradicionales. Ellos avanzan en masa, el sol en la espalda para traducir el calor intenso y su fatiga. En contraste, el Hadj, jefe del grupo, se mantiene erguido y con el torso desnudo en el centro del cuadro, protegido del sol por su fe.
Recuperamos nuestras fuerzas antes de nuestra última etapa, Tangar la Marroquí.
Te abrazamos.
July 3rd, 1890. Dear Mary,
60 years after Delacroix, we have followed his footsteps in Algeria and Morocco and France. We have just reached the last steps of our journey, Tangier de Morocan.
Eugene Delacroix drew all the time, whether he was walking, riding a horse, in his tent, in the street, or even during a ceremony.
In his letters, he describes his astonishment in front of the landscapes and the architecture, but also towards the population he meets, whose costumes and lifestyle differ so significantly from his.
With his sketches, his watercolors, and his oil paintings, Delacroix perfectly showed the diversity of techniques used by the Orientalists.
We rediscover his paintings through wandering across the city and the surrounding countryside. Like him, we are amazed. If one word could describe Tanger, it is definitely exchange. This city is benefiting from the intercultural exchange of a wide diversity of people living in peace and harmony. It is a very tolerant place. Different religions and cult places are well accepted. Mosque, synagogue or churches.
I've had the opportunity to attend to a Jewish wedding ceremony. It occurred in the inner courtyard of the house. The assembly was cosmopolitan. Not only Jews, but also some Muslims were invited. The women were sitting on the left side while the men were sitting on the right. We were all sitting in the shadow of the balcony trying to avoid the sunlight. Indeed, light in Morocco is crushing and white walls can be blinding. The food was circulating, the music was punctuating the dances. We played the round a lot, but strangely, I wonder if the bride was with us.
Like Delacroix, this journey will have transformed us. We lost our naive fantasies on the 1001 nights of it.
We are coming back rich of an Orientalism supported by real experiences. Those memories are way more profound and exceed the folkloric elements of the Orientalist art which pushed us to travel. We are looking forward to seeing you in London.